A handshake between the U.S. and China, symbolically sealing another sanctions resolution against North Korea.
I shall put the draft resolution to the vote now.
For the fourth time, the Security Council imposed sanctions on a North Korean regime increasingly bellicose after getting the news from New York. The new sanctions compel U.N. countries to block cash transfers, which pay for nuclear and ballistic missiles programs, demand enforcement globally to inspect cargo and stop North Korean arms smuggling, keep closer tabs on North Korean diplomats abroad who are accused of using their privileges to advance illegal weapons programs, and now specify a list of luxury goods that cannot be sold to North Korea, including jewels, yachts, and race cars.
Taken together, these sanctions will bite and bite hard. They increase North Korea's isolation and raise the cost to North Korea's leaders of defying the international community.
The recent rocket and nuclear tests have unnerved even North Korea's key ally, China. An out-of-control North Korea is trouble for its neighbor and trading partner.
Adoption of resolution is not for the sake of adoption, is not for the sake of the sanctions. We want to see full implementation of the resolution. The top priority now is to diffuse the tension, bring down the heat.
North Korea's frontline neighbor urged Pyongyang to cooperate and wake up from its, quote, delusion of becoming a nuclear state.
Claiming the right to preemptive nuclear strike. North Korea's provocation, whether rhetorical or physical, are completely unacceptable, and we will deal with it resolutely.
UN diplomats here say they are determined to try to change the behavior of North Korea with the sanctions resolutions, no matter how wild the threats from Pyongyang are that are being lobbed back at them here. Richard Roth, CNN, United Nations.